Good afternoon, friends. Word of Gourd. Back in the garden on another lovely sunny day here in southern Ontario, where the summer is just beginning. I'd like to continue with my reactions and critiques of the conspiracy films, the conspiracy of history, the conspiracy of politics, the conspiracy of organized religion. Reflecting on Kymatica, Zeitgeist, and the esoteric treatises of them all. I may have sounded in the first film, the first part, as though I was a little too anxious to skip by all their esoteric theorizing on history and religion and move straight to the God consciousness and the bliss of it all. So let me go backwards a little. I'm not suggesting that their views on the elites and their manipulating of the historical record and the political conspiracies are to be avoided, to be ignored, to be put aside. One certainly should familiarize oneself with these shadow plays, these manipulations of information and history. I have done such research myself over the last, at least 30 years. Going back to 1969, 1970, when I first began research on the Jack Kennedy assassination and realized that all was not as it appeared in the news media. There is much to be learned from researching these political conspiracies, but there comes a time when one leaves that behind, knowing that things have been manipulated in order for certain results to appear in the public record, certain conspirators to be named, certain patsies to be put in front of the public eye. And one realizes that whatever manipulated lies have been inserted into the historical record, one cannot ultimately change those manipulations. They will stay in the historical record. Much, for example, has been written by one, I believe, David Stinnett on the Pearl Harbor rearrangement of history. His book is called Day of Deceit, and there is as much there as you could ever wish to know about how things were manipulated for the historical record on the Pearl Harbor issue. This has come up again with the 9/11 researchers pointing out that 9/11 was a false flag operation and There is a history of false flag operations, as they have pointed out. The Nuremberg fire, the Gulf of Tonkin incident, many going back hundreds of years. This is what governments do in order to justify certain actions. And when one realizes this, one eventually gets over one's shock. Governments will sacrifice their own citizens for political ends. Banks will lie. Religions will conflate the myths and legends of other religions in order to absorb their followers into their new dispensation. Christianity has certainly absorbed the truths and legends of pagan religions into its own worldview. The ascended masters to whom I wouldn't say owe allegiance, but certainly bend my knee to in some degree because of their devotion to the evolution of consciousness on the planet and their willingness to be bodhisattvas, enlightened beings until the rest of us are following in the line of that enlightenment. The ascended masters, such as I've spoken of Maitreya, Christ, Krishna, and many others, are in fact behind the creation of most of the religions, if not all the religions on this planet, going back to Atlantis and before. They are all designed honestly and sincerely to educate the evolving consciousness of man on the planet, the incarnate man, the one who is limited by his three-dimensional experience on the physical plane. Now, the representatives of these religions, as they unfold through history, often misrepresent the original impulse and turn it into something of a prison rather than something of a liberation for its followers. But that is not to condemn religions or their religious impulse. It is up to us to see beyond the lies and delusions and manipulations and move toward the representatives of the God consciousness, the true representatives. And I urge you all to do that, one way or another. Move beyond conspiracy theory. Move beyond the manipulations of the religious impulse. Move into your personal relationship with the prophets and the God consciousness that they represent. Also like to add something I missed yesterday. As one moves to the blissful state of the God consciousness after, either during incarnation or after it in the spirit worlds, one also has the choice of, as well as going to a nirvanic state, of refusing that nirvana, turning it down, and moving to a service, a position of service on the planet, becoming a teacher, either an incarnate teacher or a discarnate teacher, a spirit guide, an archangel. This is very definitely possible, and I neglected to mention it yesterday, but I'm glad I mentioned it today. So, farewell for now.